Hello, dear children. In our last geography class, we had discussed the land resources of Karnataka, pattern of land utilization in Karnataka, and different types of cultivation practiced in our state. Today, in this session, we are going to discuss about the major crops of Karnataka. Just like different types of farming, there are different types of crops are grown in Karnataka. Soil, climatic conditions, relief features, irrigation facility, traditions of the farmers and the market are the main reason for this cultivation of different types of crops. The crops of Karnataka can be classified into three main types. They are food crops, commercial crops, and plantation crops. At first, let us understand food crops. The crops which are grown to provide food for people are called food crops. Some of the important food crops are, at first, paddy. Paddy is a very important food crop of Karnataka. Rice is the staple food for the people of Karnataka. Paddy is grown in 28.2% of the total cultivable land. Irrigation facility, use of chemical fertilizers, and high yield hybrid seeds have resulted improvement in the yield of paddy. It is a tropical crop. Cultivation of paddy requires heavy rainfall and high temperature. Cultivation of paddy requires level land. Fertile clay and alluvial soil are ideal for paddy cultivation. West Bengal is the largest producers of rice in our country. Organic manure, leaves of trees, and abandoned labors are required for the cultivation of paddy. Nearly 70% of paddy is grown during June to August month and harvested during November and December month. Paddy is a kharif crop. Even in summer, paddy is grown in area where irrigation facilities available. Normally, broadcasting and transplanting methods are used for cultivation of paddy crop. Paddy growing areas. Paddy is grown in all the districts of Karnataka. The Krishna Tungabhadra River Valley, Kaveri River Valley, and the coastal districts are famous for paddy cultivation. Raichur district stands first in the production of paddy. Jowar. Jowar is the second most important crop in Karnataka after paddy. Until recently, the area under jowar cultivation was more than that of paddy. But in recent years, it has decreased. The total area under jowar cultivation is 26% of the cultivable area. Karnataka stands second after Maharashtra in the production of jowar in India. Jowar is the staple food of people of North Karnataka. It is mainly used for preparing rotis. The stalks of jowar plant are used as cattle fodder. The botanical name of jowar is sorghum vulgare. It is a tropical crop. It requires moderate rainfall and moderate temperature. Mixed black and red soil and alluvial soil are suitable for cultivation of jowar. Jowar is a rain-fed crop and grown by using broadcasting method. It depends on the southwest monsoons. Vijayawada stand first in the production of jowar in Karnataka state. Ragi. Ragi is a very nutritious food grain. Its botanical name is Elusina coracana. It is used for preparation of malt, dosa, porridge and ragi balls. It is the third most important food grain after paddy and jowar. It is a very cheap grain. The stalks of the ragi plant are used as fodder for cattle. Ragi can be preserved for many months. Ragi is a tropical crop. High temperature, moderate rainfall, red sandy and loamy soil are suitable for the cultivation of ragi crop. It can withstand very severe drought. In some places, ragi is grown by using irrigation facilities. It is an important kharif crop. It can be grown even during summer seasons by using irrigation facilities. Karnataka stand first in the production of ragi in India. Ragi is grown in 14% of total cultivable land. The ragi growing areas are concentrated in the districts of Southern Maidan. Ragi is a traditional crop of old Mysore province. Jowar is the main crop of North Karnataka, whereas ragi is the main crop in South Karnataka. Tumkur is the leading producers of ragi. Commercial crops. Crops that are grown for the purpose of market and not for the domestic purpose are called commercial crops. The most important commercial crops grown in Karnataka, sugarcane. Sugarcane is the most important commercial crops and industrial crop of Karnataka. Karnataka ranks fourth place in the production of sugarcane. It is a tropical crop. It is grown in areas with high temperature and heavy rainfall or good irrigation facility. Sandy loamy soil and red soil are suitable for the cultivation of sugarcane. Since sugarcane has to be transported to the factories as soon as it is harvested, there has to be good transport facilities. If there is no good factories and transport facilities, sugarcane loses its weight, as it is a weight losing crop, there will be a great loss for sugarcane farmers. Sugarcane belongs to the grass family. It grows to a height of 3 meters. The botanical name of sugarcane is Sacharum officinarum. It is used for production of jaggery and sugar. Belgavi is the leading producer of sugarcane in Karnataka and followed by Bagalkot, which has irrigation facilities from Almaty project. Cotton. Cotton is the second important commercial crops in Karnataka. It is a fiber crop. It provides raw material for cotton textiles. Besides, it is used for making carpets, beds and pillows. Cooking oil is produced from cotton seeds. Cotton seed cake is used as cattle feed. Cotton is a crop of the tropical and subtropics. Moderate rainfall, high temperature and black soil are suitable for its growth. Cotton has been used for a long time in daily life in Karnataka. Long, medium and short staple cotton are the different varieties of cotton. It is a kharif crop grown August September month. It is a rain fed crop. It can also grown with the help of irrigation facility. Haveri, Dharwad, Gadag, Mysore are the important cotton producing districts of Karnataka. Haveri district ranks first in the production of cotton. Dharwad district ranks second in Karnataka. Pest and diseases are the major problem for cotton industry. Tobacco. Tobacco belongs to the nicotina group. It contains an intoxicating substance called nicotine. Tobacco is used in the manufacture of bidis, cigarettes, cigar and snuff. The Portuguese were the people who introduced tobacco in India in the 17th century. It can be grown in areas with moderate rainfall and high temperature in loamy soil. A variant tobacco known as Virginia tobacco is highest quality and is great demand in the global market, and that is grown largely in Karnataka state. Karnataka ranks fourth among the tobacco growing states in India. Mysore district occupies the first position in the production of tobacco. Nipani in Belgavi district is very famous for tobacco marketing. Coffee. Coffee is Karnataka's famous plantation and beverage crop. Karnataka ranks first in the production of coffee in India. A Muslim fakir named Baba Budan planted coffee staples for the first time around 1670 in the hills of Chikkamagalur. Hence, those hills are called Baba Budangiri. However, organized cultivation of coffee began under the British rule in 1826, and today vast coffee estate can be seen in Karnataka. Karnataka produce two types of coffee, namely Arabica and Robusta. Among these, Arabica is the better quality and enjoys a great demand in international market. Coffee is a tropical crop which can grow well on the slopes of hills with heavy rainfall. Clay mixed soil is suitable for the growth of coffee. Coffee plant cannot withstand the direct rays of sun. Karnataka has a share of 70% of the coffee production in India. It is grown largely in Kodagu district. Coffee grown in Karnataka is good in quality. Hence, it enjoys great demand both in the national and international market. That is why Karnataka is known as land of coffee.